Hi, I'm Ellie Fidelli, and I'm here with Adriana Candro, the video director here at the Commodores. So, how do you like the Commodores so far? What has been your favorite part of the season?
It's hard to pick just one thing. I really just love baseball, so being around it all summer has been like a dream to me.
How do you manage a sports team, and what goes into the job?
So the Commodores as a whole, there's like a million different like sectors and groups of interns, but me personally, we run a kids clinic, which brings in a lot of income for the team considering we're a nonprofit and entry is free. So we go through the sign up lists, we're here every morning, we make sure the kids get in, everything's safe, everything runs smoothly. And then we also do the customer relations management system for the team, which is huge because it logs in all the money we make and keeps pretty much everything organized in terms of profits. And then we also work on the back end of the website, and another huge part of our job is contacting people. So we contact our first pitch, national anthem, and play ball people, make sure they're here on time, make sure they know what they're doing, and we get some information about them for the PA as well. So it's a lot.
And how is it working for the Commodores after growing up in Falmouth?
So I actually went to the clinic that I was talking about when I was a kid, which is funny. So when I saw that they were hiring interns, I was like, that's perfect. And it's just crazy to like see how far it's come since I was young coming here. It's crazy to see it loop back around.
Well, we have a number of interns in a number of specialties, administrative, merchandising, game day operations, and my crew in particular, broadcasting and media. So in order to actually put on a game the way we put on a game, you need all this extra help in order to do it. It's fine to just have the players here, but without the support staff in place to actually do all these ancillary things, it would be much less of an overall experience for any fan who comes to the game.
I think the most challenging part was operating the equipment early on and adjusting to the press box that's brand new. Nobody's used it before except for this. We're the first team to ever use it. So getting through all the production side and then broadcasting a game into a microphone, I've never done that. I've always had a headset. So adjusting to things like that is probably the most difficult thing so far, the most challenging. My favorite part is watching baseball every night. I mean, this is the best talent in the country, best players in the country. It doesn't get better than this. So to be able to do what I love, calling games with people from all over the country, people from all over different schools, it's been unbelievable so far.
It helps whenever you have great fan support. It helps make our jobs a lot easier because that energy feeds into the broadcast. You can hear it in our voices. You can hear it in the crowd mics, all that. So as a result, it just makes our jobs a lot easier. We sound a lot better. And when you have a great community behind the team, it just makes all that work so much better. So, yeah.
For Twitter, we sort of do game updates. Leading into the game, we sort of post graphics with a photo and what team we're playing, some information like who's starting and the starting lineups. And then we sort of post when someone scores or a big out happens, a really cool play, things along those lines. And then on Instagram, we do different all-star promotion type things for players that make the all-star team or like player of the week type stuff. And then also on Twitter and Instagram, we post when someone posts an article, does an interview, whatever it may be, for Closing the Door, which is our post-game show. So it's a variety of different content we post on our social medias.
I love baseball. I always have. My family lives in Falmouth now, and I think that this is kind of the premier baseball league in the country, and I wanted to have a really fun summer. So it ended up working out really well in terms of being practical, and I don't regret it at all. It's been kind of one of the best summers of my life in terms of people I've met and experiences that I've had.